Good evening, doctors. Our today's topic is type 1 diabetes mellitus. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and I already have experience in this disease, and I already work with DM endocrinologist, so I know very, very well about this disease. So, my dear friends, please pay attention, and our today's topic is type 1 diabetes mellitus. Mainly the diabetes are two types, so I am going to explain you what kind of diabetes includes, like two types. First one are type 1 diabetes mellitus and so many others and their complications. In type 1 diabetes mellitus, what happens? This is seen mainly in children, early onset of disease, and this disease is hereditary, means genetically, like involvement of HLA-DR3 and 4. So, what was happen in type 1 diabetes? Here is the severe deficiency of insulin. Insulin deficient. Why this is insulin deficient? Because the pancreas. There is a beta cells in pancreas. There is beta cells, and what happened with this beta cell? There is damage in pancreas due to any pathological process, maybe due to mutation in gene, or sometime with virus, some viruses like mumps virus damage the pancreas, mumps virus. Like some another rubella virus, Epstein-Barr virus, and sometimes cytomegalovirus. If a child is infected with these viruses, that damages the pancreas, and that's why the pancreas is unable to produce a beta cell, and beta cell is responsible for producing insulin. So there is an insulin deficiency in these cases. And what was happen here, if insulin is deficient, so the increase in B represent here blood and S represent here sugar. So blood sugar increases in this case of type 1 diabetes mellitus. And here sometimes it's due to infection, sometimes it's autoimmune destruction of beta cells destroyed by autoimmune pathological process, and sometimes some drugs like streptozocin, anti-cancer drug. This is anti-cancer drug, also destroy the pancreas. So here what I am going to say, by all these theories, it explain that type 1 diabetes is insulin dependent. But if we are going to talk about in another section, type 2 diabetes mellitus, that is insulin resistance, but sometimes insulin deficiency. But here is insulin deficient, not resistant, they are resistance. Okay, I hope till here clear. What happens here, the patient is very thin. Very weak, but in type 2 there is fatty obese patient. Here thin patient, very weak, very dull in type 1 diabetes mellitus. So I'm going to explain you how to diagnose type 1 diabetes mellitus. We have to check the levels of sugar level, like 2-RPP means after meal, 2 hours postprandial, then fasting. In case of diabetes mellitus, I am going to explain you what happens. If 2-RPP is more than 200 milligram per deciliter, and here is more than 126 milligram per deciliter fasting. This defines the criteria of patient suffering from diabetes, not type 1 or type 2. But it is diabetes. I am going to explain you how to diagnose between type 1 and type 2. Type 1, we are going to see all these things. like patient is very thin, very weak, or some C-peptide test. But here, diabetes mellitus, it defines if 2-RPP is more than 200, fasting is more than 206, and HbA1c, glycosylated hemoglobin, if it is more than 6.5%, then what happens? It is diabetes mellitus. Then impaired glucose tolerance test. Impaired glucose tolerance test, what does it define? It defines when a 2-RPP is more than 140 and fasting is less than 126 mg per deciliter. So remember, it is between 6 and 6.5%. Okay. But in case of impaired fasting tolerance, glucose tolerance, you have to remember all these things. It is less than 140, 2-RPP, but fasting is also here. 126 till 110 milligram per deciliter. But in case of normal, a patient who is not suffering from diabetes mellitus, it's normal sugar level. I am going to tell you 2-RPP, the sugar must be here, the fasting must be less than 110, and PP, how do you think the PP must be, how much in case of normal? Also say less than 140 milligram per deciliter, and normal it is less than 6% is known as normal patient, non-diabetic patient, non-diabetic one. So my dear friends, I hope till here it's clear. There is so many complication with type 1 diabetes mellitus, and how to diagnose. I'm going to explain you one theory, like pro-insulin, how to differentiate between type 1 and type 2. Pro-insulin, it produces insulin plus C-peptide. So what happens in C-peptide test? How to diagnose in case of type 1 diabetes? We use C-peptide test. If in our body the pancreas not producing beta cell is damaged, so no pro-insulin develop. No pro-insulin develop in type 1 diabetes. So there the level of insulin going to be very low in body, and C-peptide going to be very low. So we are going to check the C-peptide level. If C-peptide level is very, very low, that indicates type 1 diabetes mellitus. But in case of type 2, what happens? This pro-insulin produces, insulin produces, but receptors are not working properly. Patient is obese and young adult, but C-peptide levels are normal. That's why in case type 2 diabetes mellitus. But in type 1, remember that type 1, type 2, I'm going to explain another section. So remember, insulin is not producing. Okay. So, insulin, C-peptide is low. Remember, pro-insulin low, then insulin low, then C-peptide low, because not producing. So, till here, I hope it's clear for you, how to diagnose the type 1 diabetes mellitus. And complication, I'm going to take another section. The most common complication in type 1 diabetes mellitus is DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. So now investigations till here, it's clear. Diabetes type 1 mellitus is associated with so many diseases. Remember hypothyroidism, hyperthyroidism, pancreatic disorders, or so many others like this. But remember till here about type 1 diabetes. I hope this is sufficient for you. Remember till here, and now I'm going to tell you how to treat type 1 diabetes mellitus treatment. So there is no drugs, we are not going to use any kind of drug in type 1 diabetes, but one drug, premelitid. This drug we are going to use in both type 1 and type 2, premelitid drug. Now the best and safe drug in type 1 diabetes mellitus we are going to use is insulin. My dear friends, if you haven't watched my lecture about insulin, so please go there and watch my video about insulin. I am going to explain you type 1 diabetes, how we need to treat, but in short way. But insulin lecture I represent individually, so it's better you have to see that lecture also. So insulin we are going to use in type 1 diabetes mellitus. The best treatment with best survival rate with the help of insulin. 4 times insulin we need to use, like basal insulin, Bustle means night time. At a bad time, when a diabetic one patient going to sleep, night time, or we can say bad time during sleep. Okay. Here include like bitter meat, glargine. This jitter meat came with the name of Lantus insulin. These are long acting, working 24 hours. 24 hours this insulin works, and here the onset starts between early in case 1 to 2 hour onset starts. Its action, onset of action start 1 and 2 hours, and it is working till 24 hours. Okay, my dear friends, the dose here, we can use 10 units during night. Okay, and it's better to see my insulin lecture. And bolus, we use 3 times: before breakfast, before lunch, before dinner, 3 times. If we are going to use, this is the best regimen, because the prognosis is going to be very good. Prognosis are going to be very well. And here we are going to, before breakfast, we can use like short acting include regular insulin, new insulin regular. This onset is starts earlier, in this case regular, or we can use short rapid acting like aspart, lispro. How to calculate the doses and everything, I already explained. We have to divide into 3 parts. 0.1 into 0.3 unit, we can take or multiply by it. So my dear friends, see here, before breakfast, if aspart 15 minutes before breakfast, lunch and dinner. If someone weight is 50 kg, so we are going to divide with like 0.1. So here answer is 0.1 into 100 if we take. So here it came 10 divided by 0, 10 units. So we are going to divide this by 10 units. So 3 unit before breakfast, 3 unit before lunch, and 3, take less better. 4 unit before breakfast, 3 unit lunch, and 3 unit dinner. So it total is 6. So we can use this. If regular insulin, also same method. Till here I hope it's clear. And the onset of action is total duration is 6 hours. Both regular and short acting working 6 hours or maybe 8 hours. I hope till here it's clear. And one insulin also, like intermediate insulin, we are not going to use in type 1 diabetes mellitus. Maybe some people are using that insulin in type 1 diabetes mellitus intermediate. That is a wrong concept, because it's better to give 4 times insulin in a type 1 diabetes mellitus, so the prognosis is going to be very good, and a child going to be survived till 80 years, I think so, because complication came late. Sometimes so many people ask me why there is a complication in diabetes. I am taking regular everyday insulin, and after that also the diabetes complication came. The main reason was that the complications occurs because you are not controlled like a normal human being insulin level, glucose level in your body. Your glucose level with the help of insulin also varies. Sometimes it's high but not normal. That's why a diabetic patient have a complications, so many microvascular, macrovascular, decay. Decay is a serious complication, I'm going to explain. It's not a chronic, it's an acute complication. So one insulin also I am going to explain here, so better to see my that video. I am very brilliantly explaining that insulin topic. Intermediate insulin. Intermediate include regular, like preparation 70 by 30, 50 by 50, or 70 by 30, 50 by 50. Yes, this is the insulin 75 by 25 preparation. These are came in market. So we have to give before breakfast and before dinner 2 times this insulin. How to calculate the dose? We have to divide it by 0.5 units into body weight. If you think it is 100, same take 100 kg main. So here came 50 units. two times. So we have to divide before breakfast it is 2/3 and before dinner it is 1/3. So 50 divided into 2 divided by 3. So here came 3 1 3 and here 20, 3 6 18, nearly 6 and 0.6 also 16.6. So 16.6 divided by 2, here it's over game, it's unit include 33.2. This is the value we have to unit, we have to so take 33 units before breakfast and before dinner 1/3 by 15 to 3. So its answer is 16.6. So before dinner we have to take 16.6 units. So my dear friends, I hope till here it's clear for you how to give insulin, but this insulin we are not going to use in type 1. In case of type 2 diabetes mellitus, we can use two ways insulin. Sliding scale nowadays it's banned, but I already explained in hospital regimen they are using. Those hospitals who are not updated, they still using sliding scale, but we are not using sliding scale and need to titrate the insulin doses. I am titrating this insulin dose. And how to treat the diabetes mellitus, never forget diabetes mellitus, the primary initial treatment is not insulin. First treatment is diet, diabetic diet. I am going to take another section in which I am going to explain diabetic diet. Diet which is diabetic, what we need to eat, what we don't need to eat. And walking and exercise. Walking and exercise is a primary treatment than insulin. So lifestyle management, my dear friends, it's came under. So as far as we think, your onset will start 15 minutes and peak 90 minutes, 3 hours and then 6 hours it was. And if you think about regular 2 to 4 hours, it peaks and 30 minute onset starts. So my dear friends, I hope till here it's clear for you. So my dear friends, and I want to explain one thing more here. Diabetes type 1 is less common, it is only 10% or 5%, but type 2 is 90% in our community. So my dear friends, okay, thank you, goodbye, have a good night,
have a good day.